Hello everyone, welcome to the channel KTU Basic Learning Mechanical Engineering. So after you watch this video, if you like it, you please press the like button, share it, subscribe the channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon. So the subject which we are going to deal is ME368 Marketing Management, and the topic is market segmentation. The market segmentation is coming under Module 3 and we are considering it as Part 1. So before going to know about this market segmentation, we should understand what is market. So market consists of buyers and sellers. It is a place where both meet each other with their particular goods and services. The buyers differ based on wants, purchasing power, geographical location, buying attitude, and buying practices. So buyers are differed from the sellers based on these five different categories: wants, purchasing power, geographical location, buying attitude, and buying practices. Now coming on to the market segmentation. So the complex buyer behavior is the root cause of the market segmentation. Since the buyers have different categories of behavior, the buying methodology becomes more complex. And that is the main reason by which market segmentation comes into action. Now, coming on to the definition of market segmentation, taking the heterogeneous market as total for a product and dividing it into several sub-markets or segments, each of which will be homogeneous. That is, we are considering the market as a heterogeneous market because different varieties of customers, different varieties of products will be there. So now that heterogeneous market is divided into several sub-markets or segments. Now that heterogeneous market has been divided into small sub-markets or segments so that we can group these product or the customer into different segments, and each of which then will become homogeneous. The method for achieving maximum response from the limited market resources. So market segment, by applying the market segmentation method, we can achieve maximum response from the limited market resources. We don't want to expend more market resources, methods like advertisement, different other publications, etc. Its essence is to identify the customer demand. So the main essence of market segmentation is to identify the customer demand. So by dividing the product or dividing the customers into small segments, we can easily identify the consumer demand. Now, benefits of the segmentation. By using the segmentation, we are able to find out the market potentialities of the product, can adjust the resources in a profitable manner based on the result from the segmentation. Changes can be implemented without losing the market, able to identify the promotional devices, able to determine the introduction of new product. That is, by using the segmentation, we can understand the market potentiality. What is the market trend, or what is the market potential, etc. We can be identified by this method. And we can also adjust the resources in a profitable manner based on the results from the segmentation. We can modify the product based on the results from the segmentation. Changes can be implemented without losing the market. So by getting the information from the segmentation method, we can make the changes without losing the market, and able to identify promotional devices. So after identifying the what are changes required, we can also give different promotional techniques. So that also can be identified with the help of the segmentation process, and able to determine the introduction of new products. So by doing these promotional devices, if our product are failure in the market, then we can determine the introduction of new product. The requirements for effective segmentation. So there are mainly three types of requirements: measurability, accessibility, and substantiality. Now the measurability means the degree to which the information exists or is obtainable on the particular buyer characteristics. So unfortunately, many suggestive characteristics are not susceptible to easy measurement. Now the second is accessibility, the degree to which the firm can effectively focus its marketing efforts on the chosen segments. This is not possible with all segment variables. The third condition is a substantiality, the degree to which the segments are large or profitable enough to be worth considering for a separate marketing cultivation. So the substantiality means whether we have to take take that particular segment into consideration is the substantiality. Accessibility means it is whether the information can be easily accessible, whether it can be focus, we can put the effort, whether we can able to put the effort to get the maximum information that is accessible. Measurability means whether there is any data to be measured. Okay, so these are the requirements for the effective segmentation. So next is segmentation variable. In the segmentation variable, we can see the four different types: geographic, demographic, psychographic, and behavioral. In the geographic variables, the main variables are region, country size, city size, population density, and climate. As we earlier discussed, geographic means it is based on a location, the location from which the consumers or the product are being placed. So here you can see the different variables here. Geographic variables mainly consist of region, country size, city size, population density, and climate. In demographic, consists of age, gender, family size, family life cycle, life stage, income, occupation, education level, religion, race, and nationality. In psychographic variable, it consists of social class, lifestyle, and personality. It also consists of different subsections in the each of the three categories. And in the behavioral variable, it consists of purchase occasions, benefit desired, user status, user usage rate, loyalty, buyer readiness, stage, attitude. So these are the different variables of market segmentation. So next is the steps involved in segmentation process. The first step is to assess the difference between customer group and other group. So first we have to identify which are the real customers and what are the other groups. So that difference has to be identified. The second one is factors to identify appropriate consumers in each segment. We have to categorize or we have to identify the appropriate consumers for the each segments. Now disaggregating the customers. So we have to then put each customers into each segments. Analyzing the possibilities of marketing programs and mixes for each segment. Then we have to identify what all marketing program has to be done for the each segment and what all marketing mixes has to be done for the each segment. Then finding the benefited segments. Then we have to find which is the real benefited segment, because we should understand which segment has a real need of particular product, and so that is the beneficiated segment. Then estimate the purchase level of each segment. So there are different segments in which different purchase level will be there. We have to identify the best one and select the segment which offer higher potential. So that higher potential segment is selected by the firm, and the other segments will be avoided. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like it, share it, subscribe the channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon for getting the new videos. Thank you.